हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सेकंड यूनिट ऑफ फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस एंड हियर वी आर गोइंग टू सी वन डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस। सो वी कैन सी फर्स्ट द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट रिगार्डिंग द लिनियर स्टैटिक एनालिसिस ऑफ बार एंड बीम एलिमेंट्स। सो व्हाट इज लिनियर स्टैटिक एनालिसिस? सो वी व्हेन वी सी most of the structural analysis problem are being treated as a linear static problem because it is based on the following assumptions. There are many assumptions which are seen over here. So first one is small deformation. So we are considering loading pattern is not enough change to due to the deformed shapes. So we are considering there may be a small deformation in the body, and we are also considering that element or that body is made of the elastic material, so no plastic deformation is there or may not happening the plasticity or no permanent failure is there. As soon as the loading is removed, then it may get the original shape and size, so that elasticity property should have with our model or with our parts. So then we are again considering the third point, so that is static element. So we are considering the load which is applied on the structure is a slow or steady load, steady type of load. So we are considering all these conditions for this one dimensional analysis, and so that is called as linear static problems. So we can provide most of the information about the behavior of structure, and that can be a good approximation for many analysis. So it is also the base on non-linear analysis. In most of the cases, what we can see, in many cases there may be non-linear analysis which can be based on the structure, behavior of structure, and other information that may be in the form of boundary conditions, apply loading, everything. So now we will see what the bar element. So we are considering the prismatic bar over here. So in the diagram we can see over here there are some notations are given over here. First I and J, two notations are given that are indicating the nodes of this bar element. So one dimensional bar is considered over here. So we are considering the forces in only one direction, the deflection or displacement ui in one direction, and also we are considering force fi in only one direction. Same is considered on the other or j node, because here we are considering uj as a displacement, fj as a force, and the length is given over here is L. So area is given over here and is indicated by E, and E is the modulus of elasticity. So we can consider here strain displacement relation. We already we know it as epsilon, that is strain is equal to change in dimensions to the original dimension, that is displacement relation will be given as del u by del x or du by dx, that is change in deflection with respect to the length or x. Okay, so stress strain relation also we know in the form of modulus of elasticity, that is stress is equal to E, that is modulus of plasticity into strain epsilon. So we can see over here the stiffness matrix or the method of solution of this component or this bar in the form of direct method. So we are assuming that the displacement is varying linearly along the x-axis, and it is given as u of x is equal to 1 upon x by L into ui plus x by L into uj. So basically we have the value for what we can say the strain is given as change in displacement, that is uj minus ui, with respect to original length, that is L. So that we can have this formula for this strain is equal to delta by L, and delta is given over here as a elongation. So the stress is given as already we have seen, that is elasticity into strain, and here we have elasticity, and we are given the value of strain, that is delta by L. So it become E delta by L. So we have the relation of force and stress, that is stress is equal to force upon area. So we can have the simplified relation in the form of force, F is equal to EA upon L into delta. Okay, so EA upon L is can be represented as K. So we will see how it can be represented as K. K is what? The stiffness. Okay, K is a stiffness, and also we can have the stiffness is force upon the what we can say the deflection or length. Okay, so EA upon L is equal to this stiffness. So the bar is acting as like a spring, and in this case we are concluding that the element stiffness matrix like this. So K is equal to, we know that K minus K minus K and K, and we know that the value of K is E upon L. So it has been put over here, E upon L minus E upon L minus E upon L and E upon L. So it has become E upon L into 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Why it is given 1 minus 1? Well, as we have seen the bar, here we have two forces are acting, two values are acting, both are in the directions. One may be in negative and one may be in positive direction. So that we have seen the two element, and that's why 2 by 2 matrix is consider over here. So this can be verified by considering the equilibrium of forces at the two nodes. As we know that K into U is equal to F. So what is K? K is the stiffness, U is the what, deflection, and it is equal to the force. So it is equilibrium equation. So degree of freedom is what, the number of component of the displacement vector at the node. So for 1D bar element, 1 degree of freedom at each node is given. So we can see this as a stiffness matrix method. Okay, so here we have this equation, that equilibrium equation will give you the solution of your displacement at each node, as well as we can have the stresses and strain calculation also. And later on we will see some problems on this method and this direct method. So we will see it in our next video. Thank you very much.